The type of person you are usually reflects in the kind of business that you're doing. What does this mean? That to improve your business, you need to improve your personality. Here's what exactly it means. That if you are financially indisciplined, it's going to be in your business. You're going to spend unnecessarily on things that you do not need. Welcome to The Business Show. My name is Darren Bartlett. I'm sitting in for Viola. But to start with, let's go for the highlight. Uganda exports to the East African member states has dropped significantly, and Tecno Camon 18 has launched in Uganda officially in partnership with MTN and Shell. The Bank of Uganda has urged banks to innovate as Orient Bank officially becomes I&M Bank.
Government should put more money in the real economy.
When we talk about the pumpkin, you may not just buy maybe foreign varieties, but you are looking at the indigenous pumpkin.
Now, it's popularly said that African problems can only be solved by the African people. Whereas that is just a theory, is it actually true as it's said? Now, from the views on the top, we want to discuss what the African problems are in terms of development, and also look at why foreign countries have continued to benefit from all the trade treaties that are signed.
As Africa, generally, and Uganda in particular, we are facing so many development challenges. And as you can see, our indebtedness is going up, poverty levels are going up, inequality is increasing, youth unemployment, we have very few industries. In fact, some people are saying that we are de-industrializing, because when you look at where we were in the 70s, 80s, and where we are now, we are deindustrializing. When you look at the environmental degradation, that things are becoming worse, you know, despite what they are telling us about GDP, about economic growth rates. But the reality on the ground, the reality is not very good. And then also the fact that our governments have done a lot, have put in place initiatives, initiatives at continental level. Right from the Lagos Plan of Action, we have Agenda 2063, we have all these initiatives like PIDA on infrastructure, very huge. We have AMV, the Africa Mining Vision, how to beneficiate our minerals and natural resources. We have now the Continental Free Trade Area. So many initiatives. And even at the global level, they have, those developed countries, they have put in place so many initiatives to help Africa get out of poverty, you know. We have signed so many agreements, you know. But despite that, we are still, the situation is worse. Yet, what they tell us is what we do. World Bank IMF told us that if we liberalize, we open up our country, you know, we promote free trade, we privatize, because the private sector is efficient. That's what they told us. Government, get out of development, give it to the private sector. You know, they would do everything. So despite that, you know, we are still poor.
Okay.
And the situation is getting worse.
All right. So it looks like we have to go back to the drawing board now and start then analyzing all these treaties we've signed. We see almost every day there are new investors coming into the country, but the outcome is almost the same. Then the question is, where is the problem, even after we, you know, privatize most of these organizations?
You see, the the challenge, the problem, is the underlying principles, the underlying ideology, you know, underpinning the policies we are following. Mm. And the economists call it the neoliberal paradigm, the neoliberal policies, which tell us liberalize the private sector. Mm? You see, you saw an ideology that is very, very key. It colors whatever you do. Maybe if I could give you an example. For example, Simon, in your, if you believe, you know, that girls shouldn't go to school, girls are good for marriage. Mm? Even if you get lots of money, you won't send a girl child to school.
Right.
So even if your brothers say, oh, Simon, maybe he doesn't have money to send Susan to school, and they give you the money, you won't do that. Mm. Mm? Again, if you are building a school, you won't build a girl's school, you build a boy's school. So that belief that girls are not good enough, they shouldn't go to school, will color whatever activities you do. So we go back to our policies. The ideology we are following, for example, privatization, private sector, let it do what it's efficient. When you compare what we are doing with our health system today, it has been privatized. But you look at what happened when it came to COVID, that even the rich were not able to access health. You know, yet health is a right, and we pay taxes to government, and government should provide health services to its people. But because of the ideology, when you look at, for example, production, we have been telling government, you can't let some things to market forces. You can't tell farmers, today they produce maize. Hmm? They produce maize, and a kilo is 100 shillings. The following day it's 1,000, the following day it's 50. Nobody is gonna produce. But government is saying, market forces, supply and demand, you know? So what we are saying, when you look at where we are today, we have no industries, you know, because government is saying it's for the private sector to be able to do that. Yet the private sector, look at Uganda. Where is the private sector to talk about? You know, they are struggling. Today they are looking for money from Ministry of Finance. You know? When you look at the private sector, its motive is profit at all cost, and we saw this during COVID. So what we are saying, we need a rethink, you know? We need a rethink, we need to rethink the role of the state. What should be the role of the state? The state should intervene directly in development. Today, during the conference, we had a Professor Eric Reinhardt, you know, from Estonia. You know, what he told us was that let us not look at what these developed countries are telling us. Let us look at how they developed. In fact, there is that great book, how rich countries became rich, and why poor countries are poor. And he's telling us, study the history of how those countries became rich.
Okay.
And they became rich by government taking control of their development, which we are not doing. They are telling us liberalize. They are telling us market forces. They are telling us private sector led. Yet even the private sector, we don't have it.
All right, so you know, I earlier talked about the fact that we have so many investors coming in. And depending on how you want to look at it, the government will tell you we have attracted investors who are creating jobs for the people. And at the end of the day, you know, this transforms into the lives of these people that are working for these investors. Do you feel or do you think that the investors that have come into the country are having a real impact on the livelihoods of Ugandans that are probably employed in there. And also too, if we know that the private sector is more into, you know, profit orientation, how then are we going to ensure that we, one, move away from doing everything that the whites or, you know, the donors are telling us to do, and look at the basics of what we need to have here as Uganda to move towards development?
Okay, thank you, Simon. I will start with the issue of investors. Again, those are the prescriptions we have been getting from outside, you know, that if we are to develop, we need to attract foreign direct investments. And indeed, government has done its best. In fact, we have laid a red carpet for investors to come in, because we have even added on to them incentives, tax holidays. But it isn't an issue of deep analysis to see whether they are providing jobs. You know, we have very high unemployment rates, and when you go, we have done some research, you know, we have gone to some of these factories, we have gone to the plantations, and the situation is so bad. The working situation there is so bad, you know. In fact, we have a case in court. We have taken government to court because of the working conditions in some plantations, you know, because government has a right to protect Ugandans. So the investors haven't really done a lot. And there is no country which has ever been developed by outsiders. And this is what we have also learned from today's phone. Somebody coming from outside to come into your country to develop it, that can't work. And that's the rethink we are talking about. And when you look at what we have provided to our investors, they come in here, they do what they want, and they take away whatever they have done. Even in our investment code, we don't have even an incentive to say, Simon, if you invest here, when you reinvest your profits, we can be able to give you some incentive. No, we tell them, take out what you have, you know, what you have done. So you find that we haven't benefited a lot from the investments, the investors. And again, it goes back to what we are saying, the ideology, what you believe in, what has been ingrained in us, that FDI is the panacea for our problems. They will bring technology, they will bring skills, they will give us employment, which they haven't done. But we continue providing incentives. And that's that we think we are talking about. In fact, when you look at our FDI, it has facilitated a lot of capital flows, you know. And we are looking for money to reinvest, and we are borrowing. Yet companies are making money and taking it out.
All right, so as we come to an end, there's a whole popular talk of how most people that have, let's say the farmers, end up selling the raw materials at ease. And like you said, we know that there's this whole problem of, I have invested so much money, I can't wait to get something off what I produced. And time and again, we've had government talk about, we should stop exporting raw materials. But who is to blame for exporting raw materials?
Government. And I have seen government shifting blame on the small scale producers, telling them that you need to add value to your produce. For me, this is unfair. let farmers produce and they let them do what they do best. Let them produce. Let those farmers get appropriate money, value for their produce. Let government ensure their industries to add value. Let government ensure that their markets. That's when they can be able to assist the private sector to be able to access those markets. But this blame game of government blaming the smallholder farmers, for me, that's the highest height of injustice.
Okay. As of October, finally, really, at the end of this October, we did see a report from Bank of Uganda indicating that there was a bit of a drop on export volumes across East African region. What does this tell us moving forward?
That there is a drop?
Yes, in export volumes of goods to from Uganda to East African countries, member countries.
You see, there has been a drop in our exports. There are so many reasons why there is a drop. And there has been a consistent drop. You know, because, for example, we used to export a lot to Rwanda. That market has ended. But again, when you look at our production, it isn't that organized. It's like it's by chance. You know, one time, somebody was asking me, well, Uganda, what do you export? I was coming from South Africa. You know, somebody gave me a lift from Pretoria to Johannesburg. I was saying, are you from Uganda? I said, yes, yes. Okay, he was, Africans. Mm. Oh, yeah, sorry, I haven't been to Africa, mm. You know? I said, wow, okay, yeah. Because, you know, they think Uganda and above, that's Africa.
Yeah.
I haven't been to Africa. I said, it's okay. But, okay, Uganda, what do you export? I said, okay, we export coffee. Oh, I haven't seen, I see coffee from Ethiopia. What do you export? So what I'm saying, Simon, our production is by chance, by luck.
I guess countries like Uganda will need to take a huge step forward if we are to attain the desired development that we need. Now, you can follow me on at Bartlett Darren and also at Kusasra Viola for all the information that you may need about this business show. Let's take this break, and when we return with more on Making Money.